But I want to be clear and forthcoming, and I hope this will not be a surprise to anyone. The Obama administration will not seek to revive negotiations on a verification protocol to the convention. We have carefully reviewed previous efforts to develop a verification protocol and have determined that a legally binding protocol would not achieve meaningful verification or greater security. It is extraordinarily difficult to verify compliance. The ease with which a biological weapons program could be disguised within legitimate activities and the rapid advances in biological research make it very difficult to detect violations. We believe that a protocol would not be able to keep pace with the rapidly changing nature of the biological weapons threat. Instead, we believe that confidence in BWC compliance should be promoted by enhanced transparency about activities and pursuing compliance diplomacy to address concerns. I know that there are some who may disagree with us on this decision. Instead, I would urge you to join us in implementing the more robust BWC activities already underway. We want to develop a rigorous, comprehensive program of cooperation, information exchange, and coordination that builds on and modifies, as necessary, the existing work program approach. As we look forward to the 2011 review conference, the United States believes that a reinvigorated, comprehensive work program is the best way to strengthen the convention. So I would ask you to demonstrate your good faith and commitment to the BWC by joining us in increasing transparency, improving confidence-building measures, and engaging in more robust bilateral compliance discussions. To highlight our three areas of emphasis in this area, let me provide a bit more detail on our goals. First, we seek to promote confidence in effective treaty implementation. A key consideration related to any treaty is the ongoing need to promote confidence in compliance. We believe that the greater emphasis should be placed on voluntary measures to provide increased confidence. We must also increase participation in the existing confidence-building measures. We should work together to review the confidence-building measure forms to assess their effectiveness and identify areas for improvement. States parties, in conjunction with the implementation support unit, should provide appropriate assistance to meet these goals. In a gesture of our transparency, I want to announce that the United States will invite the 2010 chairman to visit our National Interagency Biodefense Campus in Maryland. The facilities there include the high containment laboratories of three different United States government agencies and provide an excellent opportunity to highlight the steps we are taking to ensure safe and secure research for the benefit of public health. And we want to work toward posting future annual CBM submissions on the public access side of the Implementation Support Unit website, and we will encourage other parties to follow suit. As part of this effort, we must seek to make membership in the BWC universal. We will be looking to work with you on outreach efforts to countries that have not yet joined the convention. Second, we will seek to enhance cooperation through the BWC on natural and deliberate disease threats to complement the work being done by the World Health Organization and other international bodies. In order to implement our Article 10 commitments, it is critical that we work together to achieve, sustain, and improve international capacity to detect, report, and respond to outbreaks of disease, whether deliberate, accidental, or natural. This includes implementation of the World Health Organization's international health regulations. Fundamentally, if we improve a country's ability to respond to natural outbreaks, we have improved their capability to deal with bioterrorism. In this respect, the United States is dedicated to continuing our substantial assistance, and we want to work closely with other BWC states parties to enhance and coordinate these efforts, including through the G8 Global Partnership, United Nations Security Council Resolution 1540, and other mechanisms. The BWC should be fully utilized as a forum to inform states' parties of bilateral and regional activities, to consult on new avenues of multilateral engagement, and to promote the support of the international community. Greater cooperation and technical assistance are keys to achieving and sustaining these capabilities. We need to prevent biological weapons use and to combat infectious diseases. To this end, the Center for Disease Control will soon become the world's first World Health Organization collaborating center for implementing international health regulations. It will assist the WHO and other international partners to help build the necessary global infrastructure to fully implement the IHRs in all six WHO regions. In May, we propose a two-day meeting to share information on offers to support IHR implementation, hear from those receiving assistance about their experiences, and to make specific suggestions for improvement. We will follow up with a meeting in August that builds on the May discussion and looks at new technologies and new approaches to build the core capacities on disease surveillance needed under the IHRs. As a final piece of our strategy to enhance this forum, we want to make the BWC the premier forum for discussion of the full range of biological threats, including bioterrorism, and mutually agreeable steps states can take for risk management. The BWC should provide an international forum for advancing the dialogue on pathogen security and laboratory biosafety practices, and for promoting legislation, guidelines, and standards through cooperation and partnership. We must work here to develop international standards and practices for these important elements that advance our mutual security. To this end, we would like to announce that our FBI and CDC have developed best practices and guides on the conduct of joint criminal and epidemiological investigations of suspected intentional biological threats or incidents. We will bring our experts to discuss this in more detail at the August experts meeting. We also propose a workshop just after the August experts meeting where all interested countries can share information on bio risk management training, standards, and needs. The threat of a bio attack is much like other transnational threats and challenges we face today: climate change, nuclear proliferation, food security. We're all in the same boat, and none of us, no matter how big, can afford to go it alone. The United States takes biological weapons threats very seriously, and that's why we have adopted an energetic new approach that is tailored to counter today's threats. In closing, I want to thank you for this opportunity to reaffirm the Obama administration's support for revitalizing the BWC. I hope to join you once again at the 2011 Review Conference, and as we continue to move forward together on the critical work of countering biological threats. Mr. Chairman, it's been an honor to appear before you today. Thank you very much for the time, and I hope to continue to work together for these very, very important issues. Thank you.